Today I'm going to make a homemade TV antenna that is awesome, and it's going to be capable of picking up HD channels. Here's what you need. 10 feet of bare copper wire. You're going to need something to cut the wire with. Balum, outdoor or indoor matching transformer. Need some wood screws. You're going to need some washers. We're going to need a drill and a piece of wood. This is the piece of wood I'm going to use. It's about 3 feet tall, I want to say. We have our drill. And I will link up in the sidebar the plans for this project that I found online. Links over that way in the sidebar. Also, if this video is really helpful, please subscribe to my channel. I'd really appreciate it. Help me out. I help you out. You'll be getting all these videos right there in your inbox. And you'll also need a Sharpie. Here are our schematics, which are over in the sidebar. We're going to start off by making our first bend. Straight across. It's going to be 142 millimeters. Take your measuring tape. Measure off 142. That's in millimeters. I'm just going to put a little mark here on the wire. That's where our first bend is. Next one, the angle coming down, is 180. So let's go ahead and measure that out. Straighten it out a little bit, though. This is a 6-gauge copper wire. I read on the guy that I got this from, I read on his blog, that 12-gauge is a little bit easier to bend. My Lowe's did not have any 12-gauge. So I opted for the 6. Alright, made another mark at 180. So we're going to have 6 sections of 180. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Once you have 5 marks in between each 180, you're going to get down to the last little straight part, like the top was. And it's 142. So once you make 5 ticks after 180, whenever you're divided into 6 sections, we're going to make another 142. Once you have that done, this last mark is where we're going to cut, because we're going to have 2 rods. Notice that I kind of straightened mine out as I was making my tick marks. Eventually, you're going to want it to be straight. You can do it either before or after. And once we get it straight and we have 2 pieces, we are going to bend these into desired form to give us the best reception. Now, let's take our cutters, and we're going to snip right at that 142 mark, the last one we just made. And that completes the wire, first wire, one side. So let's go ahead and snip that. Of this project, these snips are actually the most expensive thing, which was $17.99. The wire cost me about $8 to $10. Washers and screws were probably a total of $5. A little balloon was, I think, $2. So you're getting a really cheap antenna here, and it's supposed to be better than any indoor antenna that you'll find. Let's mark up the second wire now. This one will actually be a little bit easier because you can just straighten it out and put it up against your other wire and just use the markings from that wire to figure out where all your bends are going to be. So I'm going to straighten out this wire and then I'm going to put some marks. So I straightened out my second piece here. I didn't worry about this little bottom part here. It's a little bit extra. I went ahead and laid it down next to the other one. And see, we have a little bit of extra here, so I'm going to clip it right here. Now let's take our new piece and we're going to mark it up with the piece that we've already marked. Right here, we have a mark right next to this one. We're going to add a mark right there. And we're going to do the same thing here. And do this for all your marks along the copper wire. Now we're going to bend our copper wire. The middle sections are going to be 90 degree. The top sections are going to be straight. So these are our 142s, 180, 180, 180, 180, 180, 180. So this is our middle point right here. I'm going to use my piece of wood here. That way I get an exact 90 degree angle. And we'll bend.
See, I just put the mark right there on the edge of the wood.
So now we have our next mark. Needs to bend the opposite way of that one. And we're gonna bend this one. I'm gonna keep doing this all the way along the wire, except for whenever I get to the ends, and we're gonna bend it to where it's more of an obtuse angle and not a right angle.
Alright guys, I got my middle bends here done, and now we need to bend the ends right at the 142, which is right here.
We want to bend it so that it's gonna be
perpendicular to the piece of wood. About like that.
And I already did it on the other side. So now I just basically need to get this flat. So I'm just going to sit here and kind of flatten it out the best I can. We got one side done here. Now we just need to do the other side. It's going to look the exact same way. So you can just put it up next to it and make the bends. It'll be an exact mirror of the other one. And then we'll get to nailing it onto the wood. So I got my second one here, looking exactly like the other one. I just need to flatten it out. What I've been doing to flatten them out the easiest is I take my piece of wood and I put it right down on it. And just stand on it. Walk on it. This should help flatten it out for you. So I got it flattened out good enough. Now let's get to nailing it. So I have out my piece of wood here, and I put the copper wire on top here. What we need to do is put a little hole here. We're going to put a nail in with a washer on it, and now I'm going to nail it into place. Or screw it into place, I guess I should say. Start in the middle. In between these two, actually, we need to measure this. The gap is 44 millimeters. This wood piece is 13 and a half. Divided by 3 is 4.5. Measure that out. There. We need 44 millimeters in between here. That will give it to us. Grab a screw and a washer. We're going to drill that baby in. Am I in reverse? Yes, I am. Grab you another screw and washer. Go ahead and measure this out. Let's do the third one on this wire. Now let's do the other side. We already marked our holes, so we just need to attach. One. Last one. Alright, let's just straighten out our little feelers down here. That's what I like to call them. Let's get this one here. Looking good. Straight. Alright, that's looking good. Now, we have our balum. Basically, we're going to attach these to the wire here. I guess I should have put it under the nail. Bring it up. Perfect. Y'all want to give it a test? So from what I have read, that should be all you have to do. I'm gonna go bring this to the attic and let's see what happens.
Let's go into the attic now, guys.
Here is my antenna. I've run a cord. This is the one that goes out to over here, which leads to our living room. And I noticed that the digital channels work on digital TV. They're not gonna work on the old analog TVs. So you should have bought one of those converter boxes. So now let me go downstairs and I'm gonna show y'all the quality of the programming. So this is ABC, CBS, Fox. Not too sure what this one is yet. LPB, another LPB, and another LPB. NBC, this is 1080i. I don't know which one this is. And then we goes back to the regular air channels and we get the Jesus channel. We get some wrestling. Then we also catch the CW in digital. I don't even know what this one is, but we catch it. Catch four important ones, but we catch about, I don't know, 10 others or so. And all off of that antenna made out of copper nails and wood. You want to get rid of your cable bill if you don't watch any of the other channels. If you just watch CBS, ABC, NBC, and Fox, save, I don't know, what is it, $20 a month? There you go.